This is what's happening. This is how Microsoft is, in fact, not making the Surface Duo better. They're now actively making it worse for me. What's going on, everybody? It is that lovely time of the month where the Surface Duo receives its monthly software update. We all wait around all month, hoping, praying, wishing that that update would come and that it would bring sizable, meaningful changes to the Surface Duo. So it is April the 20th this time when they finally pushed this update out. I'm making this video a couple days later because I was waiting for the change log to go live so I could really see what was happening. So I'm going to kind of talk here briefly about what happened with this update, what the change log actually is, and then what my experience has been. I'm also going to show you kind of the general response I'm seeing on the internet. So the first thing that we need to look at is the actual changelog, and I just tweeted this. I wasn't seeing the changelog for like a while. I was actually just complaining about how there was no changelog. Someone tweeted at me and said, the changelog is out. It'd be Steven here. Steven here tweeted at me and said, there is a changelog, and I said, why am I not seeing it? I'm refreshing, and there's no changelog. It's from March still. And so I cleared my cache. And then there's the changelog. So I'm not sure exactly when this actually went live, but here we are. All right, so here's what it says. Address the scenarios outlined in the Android security bulletin, such as your general, you know, security patch. Improves device stability and UI stability. I think we've seen that many times. Improves device performance when opening and closing apps, accessing your recent apps, or swiping up to see all of your apps. Fixes a scenario where the wallpaper was not appearing after unlocking Surface Duo. So maybe that's that black wallpaper nonsense. Fixing the scenario where a notification badge appears on top of a running app and causes the screen to turn black. All right, not sure exactly what they're talking about there, although the screen turning black is something that we are going to talk about here shortly. So I tweeted when it came out, here I am, I'm going to install that update. I install it, I reboot. Within a couple of minutes of rebooting, I'm holding my Duo, and I get this. The right screen shuts off. It shuts off, and it shows me the double tap to switch screens thing. So basically, the Duo thought that it had been folded over into phone mode, and that's, you know, obviously not the case because I am in a case that won't allow that. Yet the Duo thought it was actually folded all the way around. Then I closed and opened it back up again, and then I got this screen. So now I'm holding it upright. It thinks it's sideways, and it thinks that it's folded around in phone mode. So within just a few short minutes of installing this update, things were looking a little bit rough. I got a response to that from David Gibson. Mine also has introduced that problem, and it hasn't gone away. Sigh. Okay. I've had this issue now four or five times since this update. I'd never seen it before. I'm seeing it with some frequency now. And unfortunately, so I go over to the Surface Duo Facebook group. We have a post here of someone saying the same thing and the same thing. This is happening to people. You go over to the Reddit, the subreddit for it. I have noticed a bug that comes up randomly. The phone in book mode thinks it's in phone mode. Okay. I've had other people tweet it at me. Had several people tweet it at me at this point. So this seems to be a somewhat widespread bug. So that is the primary thing, the primary feature that has been brought to us by the April update is the one screen just shuts off because it thinks it's in phone mode even when it's not. I will say this though. When you are just in, you know, everything's working correctly, right? And you're just opening and launching apps, launching, closing apps, doing things, moving around, and so forth and so on. Everything's moving really nice and smoothly. And I do think that it might be fair to say that things seem to be moving in a pretty nice, smooth way. When everything's working, the Duo, it might feel faster, it might feel smoother than it did before. But for me, the problem I needed to have fixed were some of the bugs I was experiencing needed to go away. And in fact, what's happened is they've actually introduced a bug that seems to be maybe worse than the bugs that caused me to remove my SIM in the first place. When that bug appeared, I had rebooted and I'd opened up a couple of apps and I thought to myself, this thing feels quite smooth. It feels very good right now. And I kid you not, I had begun to peel the side of my Z Fold's case off to get to the SIM tray because I was going to move my SIM over. And that's when I picked up the Duo and the one screen was black. And I put the cover back over the SIM and I said, I guess not. I guess the SIM will stay in the Z Fold 2. Has this patch fixed my issues with the Duo? Hell no. It has made it worse. There's a poll on the Facebook group for the Surface Duo, and I'm going to scroll up here and find it because I'll show it to you. And this will tell you, kind of show you the vast differences and variations in how people are experiencing the Surface Duo. After the update, 16 votes said phone's running a lot smoother and faster. Yes, when it's not doing really weird things, it does seem to be running faster. 7 votes for a little faster, 4 votes for the same, 3 votes for worse. I have to say it's worse because it's even buggier than it was before. When it's not being really buggy, it does seem a lot faster and smoother for me. I will say that, it does. And then for them to take so long, at least over a day, to get the change log out, it is enough to make people kind of start to question things, to wonder what exactly is going on. I'm going to see if I can get it to actually replicate. So here we are. I mean, like, it's happening that often for me. I literally just picked the thing up and unlocked it. So since I sat down at this table, it has now done it twice while just sitting here. This is what's happening. This is how Microsoft is, in fact, not making the Surface Duo better. They are now actively making it worse for me. This is two patches in a row, two updates in a row, where it has gotten considerably worse for me. And for anyone that's in the comments that's already typing up their comment to say, factory reset, factory reset. I factory reset this thing. Oh, it just came back. I factory reset this thing after the last update, and it did nothing for me. It did not help me at all. I'm not doing it again. I'm just not, because it's not going to help. And if it did, you know, look, maybe there's like a 1% chance that it helps, whatever. I don't care. I shouldn't have to do that. You shouldn't be releasing updates that force me to have to erase all my data just to get my phone to work correctly. Let's just see what happens. I'm going to open it up. One screen was black there for a second. I'm sure you all saw that. Let's do it again. It is literally confused about this almost every time I'm opening it. The only thing I do want to add, just in case anyone wants to say this in the comments and say, you've got a case on, maybe that's caused the problems because my bumpers were causing problems on this exact Duo in the past. With the bumper off, it still is occurring. It's occurring at a lower rate. And I've discovered that in literally the last few hours, taking that case off, the Norev case here, which I've taken off. I literally filmed a bit and then played around with it more, took the case off and then messed around with it. And I'm coming back to it now to finish this video. It is lessened. I wanted to make sure that I checked that out for you guys. And it is lessened, but it is still occurring. So if you've got a case or a bumper on there, I don't know, maybe that's exacerbating the problem. But definitely taking the case off or the bumper off, for me, did not fix the problem. This is a software problem. This is something that they've done. It almost feels to me like they're trying to get that balance correct of the Duo knowing, you know, it's rotated, it's flipped, what's happened. And maybe they've overshot, but they've screwed something up. And it also points to the idea that there must be some sort of variation from Duo to Duo, pieces of hardware to hardware. Something's not being consistent from actual device to device, because you could set the parameters as they are, and if every device is the same, it should work the same. Why are some people having this issue, some aren't? Who knows? Something very strange is going on with this device, because I talk about my camera flipping around and it switching screens before when in phone mode in particular, but I've never had this issue of being in book mode and it doing weird things like this. Well, now we've introduced more problems. So the problems that kept me from daily driving my Duo after the last month's update, they've now added to them a brand new issue that's actually even worse than the prior issues. So that's been my experience with the April update for Surface Duo. It's definitely frustrating. Guys, I'd love to know what you guys are experiencing in the comments down below. Are you seeing this bug? Is this news to you? What is your Duo doing right now? That's what mine's doing. Like I said, it feels faster when it's not freaking out. So I don't know what to make of that. You tell me. Stay tuned for more coverage just like this. And until next time, stay nerdy, my friends.